Hello and welcome to the 95th session in the AISafety.com reading group. Tonight we'll be discussing an article called Mastering Chess and Shogi by Self-Play with a General Reinforcement Learning Algorithm by David Silvers and a number of other authors. The three primary authors of the article are David Silver, Thomas Schubert and Julian Schrittweiser. There are a number of secondary writers, all from Google DeepMind, including Demis Hassabis, the founder of DeepMind. The article is a comparison with AlphaGo Zero, an algorithm which has recently achieved superhuman performance in Go by clean slate reinforcement learning from games of self-play. And this paper is about a generalization of the approach into a single algorithm that can achieve superhuman performance in many different domains. Let's start with chess and shogi. Everybody, of course, knows the game of chess, and there have been a very rich and long tradition of chess programs throughout the history of computation. These are very, very domain specific, made by chess grandmasters, and cannot generalize to other domains at all, basically. Things like the weights for the algorithms are tuned very, very carefully. The way positions are evaluated is an art form, and there are many clever tricks and knowledge about chess encoded in these algorithms. The best program from 2016 was called Stockfish. This is the logo. And in comparison, Shogi, also called Chinese chess, is placed on a larger board, which gives substantially more options, also because the rules allow for substantially more flexibility. There's been a somewhat slower progress in this. The best program is called Elmo, which has only just become capable of defeating the world champion. Go is an ancient Chinese game, which turns out, which people have long thought would be very, very difficult for computer algorithms to solve, and they have been really difficult for these kind of domain-specific tricks to make headway on. But it turns out that Go, when you look at it, it's actually quite suited for neural networks, because the rules are the same whether the action happens a bit to the left or to the right. That's called translation, and the way neural network, they often have self-loops called convolutional networks, and they share the weight, which corresponds in a beautiful way to this translation. Compared with chess, however, the rules are very different according to, or somewhat different according to, where on the chessboard you are. Pawns, for instance, become queens when they reach the final row. Also in Go, the rules are the same whether you rotate it or whether you reflect the situation. And this also makes it more amenable to neural network training. In chess, however, the differences, it's not rotationally symmetric, you can't move a pawn backwards and things like that. The rules of Go only refer to the adjacent points, which is a very interesting and positive feature compared to neural networks, which also have this kind of local structure. Unfortunately, chess is much more complex in this case. You have many chess pieces that can move non-locally. Finally, there's no draw in Go. You can only win or lose, whereas obviously in chess and also in shogi, you can draw. And it's not immediately clear what you can infer from a draw, whether that's good or bad. Now let's compare AlphaZero and AlphaZero Go, or AlphaGo Zero. The AlphaGo Zero algorithm used deep convolutional neural networks and reinforcement learning from self-play. And it used this symmetry, rotational symmetry that we just talked about, to generate more training data from the human training games, and also rotated and reflected to reduce some bias in the algorithm. They also used a somewhat strange technique that I couldn't immediately figure out. Where in the iterations, they required a 55% win rate to replace the opponent for self-play. I think it's probably because it's more stable. It doesn't go out into some very, very narrow advantage case, but I'm not really sure about that. And of course, it's a the goal with Alpha Zero is to have a similar algorithm, but make it more generic and not utilize these tricks. Basically, you just implement the rules of the game and set this algorithm to work, and then you get superhuman performance. There's a mathematical description of how it works in the paper. I'll just go through it reasonably quickly. The neural network is this is the formula for what is actually going on. The F is a function, it's a deep neural network, and this is weighted, has parameters theta, and the input of the neural network is a board position. The output is a vector of move probabilities. You could also just take the maximum, which is the best move, right? So the neural network takes from a given board what is the best next move. And this is a bit more, in practice you would want a vector of moves where for each move you give the probability that you will have this move for each action, given the state. The output, V, is the expected outcome of the game. So that's the second part that is returned from this neural network. One of the key mathematical constructs used in this algorithm, apart from, of course, neural network, is the Monte Carlo tree search. This is a randomized algorithm. That's why I've used this casino logos here to illustrate. It has advantages and disadvantages. The big advantage is that it converges to the correct solution, to the best option, but it and it does not need any kind of evaluation function, which is where a lot of the chess algorithms make a lot of tricks. The problem with this is that it's very slow. Last week we talked about the algorithm iterated distillation and amplification, and I've reused some of the graphs here with the idea of a distillation. That is, you take a very complex and slow Monte Carlo tree search and you distill this into the parameters of a neural network. The values from this are amplified in some way. And this is then again distillated. So this is the amplified in a way that can be slow. This is what Paul Cristiano has talked about in his previous article, and he wrote that this was inspired by AlphaZero, and here we'll see in more details how AlphaZero does this. Each Monte Carlo tree search consists of a series of games that it plays with itself, or just a simulation basically, that can be seen as a tree from the root to the leaf, where each step down the tree is as one suggestion for where to put up a go marker. So that's basically a game. And the way this works is that it selects a move that it has not visited often, and which has high value according to the current neural network. So this is a process that takes a lot of time. It is slow, but it amplifies the ability of this neural network. So this is the amplification step. Now, the parameters of deep neural network, it's now trained through reinforcement learning, where it plays against itself. And the parameters of the neural network theta are updated to minimize the error or the difference between the outcome predicted by the neural network and the game outcome from the Monte Carlo tree search. So it maximizes the similarity of the policy and the search probabilities. This is the distillation step. And of course, this distillation is then fed into a new amplification step in the iteration. In the next iteration, basically. So compared again with AlphaGo Zero, one of the things that AlphaGo Zero did was it tuned hyperparameters. That's not the, the parameters of a neural network is generally called the weights. The hyperparameters are the parameters on the level above that, like the number of nodes and things like that. I used Bayesian optimization, which is a reasonable standard technique for this. AlphaZero doesn't do that, it just uses the same parameters for all games, both Shogi and Chess and Go. The only difference here is that it adds a bit of noise to ensure that there is some kind of exploration. And this is the more numbers that are, the more moves that are typically legal, the more noise you need to add to ensure that it tries everything, that it searches broadly. Another difference from between AlphaGo Zero and AlphaZero is that it uses a different kind of processor called a tensor processing unit instead of a graphical processing unit. The results given from this are included in the paper, and of course it's a separate instance of AlphaZero from each game, so it's not the same neural network that is trained for all these three games. It's the same executable, basically, that you run three times and then it learns and then plays the game separately, and it's restarted between each. In chess, it takes 4 hours before AlphaZero is better than Stockfish. In Shogi, it takes less than 2 hours before it outperforms Elmo. And in Go, it outperforms AlphaGo Lee after 8 hours. AlphaGo Lee is the version that beat Lee Sedong. Sorry, that's wrong pronunciation. And there have been improvements on AlphaGo Zero after that. So, but that was the baseline. There's a substantial difference from how this works. Because the Monte Carlo tree search, it's possible to search much, much fewer positions compared to what Stockfish and what other programs do. So it's a much more narrow search because it can focus on the most promising variations. And this, the authors of the paper write, is a more human-like approach to search as originally proposed by Claude Shannon. So this is a very interesting quote. Another thing, one variation they tried in the end was to look at the openings humans prefer in chess. Like there's, they have a lot of numbers because we have a very, very rich history of chess. Like there's a Sicilian opening and an Indian opening and all these things, and tried to run this algorithm on them. And for all of these, AlphaZero beats Stockfish. So it's not just that it's gone extremely narrowly into one tree. It's because it has to some extent really mastered chess in a broad sense. That is all for today. See you again next week.